Good afternoon, everyone. I'm not sure if you can hear it, but I'm outside. It's too beautiful of a day to be inside. It's just an absolutely perfect day today. And I thought what I would talk a little bit about Buddy, just quickly, just to kind of lighten the mood. One of my viewers absolutely fell in love with Buddy, and he is very lovable. Let me tell you, this dog does not have a mean bone in his body. Now, he's a recent addition, and I went to the local shelter looking for a companion dog for Britty because Britty is a Clumber Spaniel and they have a lot of hound in them. And I don't know, these working dogs, if you don't give them a specific job to do, they will lay around all day and sleep. And that's what she does. So she's gaining too much weight, she wasn't moving around. And Buddy was brought in to be more of a companion to her, and he's absolutely perfect. When I laid eyes on him, he's actually the same size as her. It's kind of the same body build. He's a basset hound mix. You can see from his body shape that he's a basset hound. Now, he probably has several other things mixed in. It's hard to say what it is. I want to say a little bit of Rhodesian Ridgeback without the ridge, because he's got the red dog collar. But anyway, he was actually adopted and brought back, and so he's been fairly traumatized. The reason that people brought him back was because he had separation anxiety terribly, and they said he chewed through his metal crate. Well, obviously he's not crate trained, so the chewing out of it part, I'm not really sure. I really can't see him doing that, but the separation anxiety, how he does it, he doesn't rip up anything. He doesn't tear anything apart. What he does is he pees or poops or both in the house. So I think that was the real reason they brought him back. But we cured him of his separation anxiety fairly quickly. I have what I call my go-away treats, chew bones, and what I did over time was every time I leave the house, when I come back, I ask him if he was a good boy. He's all excited to see you, and he gets a treat. So now he's absolutely cured of his separation anxiety accidents, I guess you could say, and actually looks forward to me leaving now. So see, you can fix it. You can fix anything. But Buddy was broken in spirit, and how I know this is because he's very fearful of everything, especially anything in your hand. So for example, if I take I When I first got him, I took a frying pan out of the cabinet and he ran for cover. If I bring a broom out just to sweep, he ducks and covers. So somebody had been very abusive with him. I'm sure of it. I'm absolutely sure of it. And I don't know. I'm guessing a lot of old school dog training was very Nazi-like, you know? It was cruel, and the idea was to break the animal's spirit to get them to complete submission and obedience. And I have a feeling that was sort of done to him because there's just too many signs that he's been hit a lot. So, Buddy, everybody loves Buddy. I just want Buddy to love Buddy and know how special he is. And he's getting there. So, thanks for enjoying him. And there's a little bit of Britty in there, but she's my Britty brat. She's a spoiled one, that's for sure. So some of her good qualities and not so good qualities are rubbing off on him, but that's okay too. So I hope my viewer who loves Buddy enjoyed this as well as everyone else. Peace out.